Good morning, students. I hope that you all are keeping well. Let's see the poem today, Your World by Georgia Douglas Johnson. So, before starting the poem, let's read something about the poet. So, Georgia Blanche Douglas Camp Johnson, better known as Georgia Douglas Johnson, was an African-American poet, one of the earliest African-American female playwrights, and an important participant in the Harlem Renaissance. The Harlem Renaissance was an intellectual, social, and artistic explosion centered in Harlem, New York, spanning the 1920s. It is considered to have been a rebirth of the African-American arts. Johnson wrote songs, plays, short stories, taught music, and performed as an organist at her church. She is also known for her collection of poetries, which are The Heart of a Woman, 1918, Bronze, 1922, An Autumn Love Cycle, 1928, and Share My World in 1962. So, this was a little description about the poet Georgia Douglas Johnson. So, I will recite the poem for you, and I want that you should also open your book and recite the poem along with me. So let's start. Your World by Georgia Douglas Johnson. Your world is as big as you make it. I know, for I used to abide in the narrowest nest in a corner, my wings pressing close to my side. But I sighted the distant horizon, where the skyline encircled the sea, and I throbbed with a burning desire to travel this immensity. I battered the cordon around me and cradled my wings on the breeze, then soared to the uttermost reaches with rapture, with power, with ease. So, this is the recitation of the poem. Now, first four lines. I'll explain the first four lines to you, that what does the poet says, or first of all, student, let me explain you about the summary of the poem. The summary of the poem tells that the poem is about self-discovery. So the poem is about, I'm telling you, the poem is about self-discovery that lead us to new worlds of feeling, acting, and living in ways you never thought were possible before. The poet likened herself to the bird. You can see in the picture, the poet likens herself to a bird whose wings were at first pressed closely to her side. In the fourth line, you can see my wings pressing close to my side. This tells us that she describes that herself to a little bird whose wings were first pressed closely to her side, which describe the state of one who is conditioned by circumstances, such as home environment. You can see here it has been given. Narrowest implies that such a home environment to acquire feeling of inferiority, to be complacent, fearful and reticent, but who soon realize that there is an exciting world of endless possibilities out there that beckons. For this reason, the poet began shattering all those things that delimit and make her hesitant to explore worlds beyond that she already knows and describes, the act of doing so as surprisingly very easy, and the freedom and levels of success she has achieved and she knows she still will achieve as rapturous and powerful. The poem is inspiring call for everyone to be brave and willing to reach out for a life that is real, fulfilled and true. So here, the first stanza, you can see the first four lines. Your world is as big as you make it. I know, for I used to abide in the narrowest nest in a corner, my wings pressing close to my side. So the first stanza describes how the narrator would follow the norm in the life and show and how she never really felt accomplished. So everyone has his or her own little world and each of them is unique. The poem Your World by Georgia Douglas Johnson indicates the message of how you can expand your world by exchanging or achieving goals and not giving up. She uses symbols to represent the message in the poem and create stage how to succeed. This is why this poem is very inspiring. So as she says that, in the first stanza, the first four lines, the poet says that our world is as big as we make it, which means we are the creators of our own destiny. She shares a part with her life when she was restricted by society in following her dreams. She felt as she was in a narrow nest, like a bird pressing its wings to the side, longing to fly but unable to. So the first stanzas tell that our world is very big, as I have told you, and she shares the part of her life that she was restricted by the society in following her dreams. She was not able to achieve her dreams and she felt that as she was in a narrow nest, like a bird pressing its wings to her sides, longing to fly, but she was unable to fly. So the first stanza tells you that. Now coming to the second stanza, but I sighted the distant horizon where the skyline encircled the sea, and I throbbed with a burning desire to travel this immensity. So the meaning of immensity is extremely large or great world. So in these lines, the poetess Georgia tells us that she began to realize her dreams and ambitions in life. So many of you are having the ambition to become something in life. So here poetess Georgia also tells about her dream that her dreams and ambitions in life and felt the urge to reach them, to make them true, to be successful. Hence, she started to fly like a bird. You can see a little girl, the poetess herself, imagine her as a bird. So she started to fly like a bird in order to accomplish her goals in life with determination and perseverance. So the second stanza tells you about the poetess who is urging to fly away like a bird, and she wants to accomplish her goals with a strong determination that I'll not give up unless and until I'll not reach my goal or accomplish my goal. She wanted to become something. So in the last paragraph, let's move to the last stanza, not paragraph, stanza. In the poem we use stanza. In the last stanza, I batter the cordons around me and cradle my wings on the breeze, then soar to the uttermost reach is with rapture, with power, with ease. So in the last stanza, the poetess explains her struggling of breaking free from the social barriers and restriction imposed on her by the society in order to fly high and reach her destined goal. Means the aimed goal. As a bird spread his wings and fly with the help of the wind, in the same way, the poetess, she builds within her the strong determination to pursue her dreams, and she found the strength to follow and reach her goal within herself. So she is very strong in herself, and she has a strong determination in her heart and mind to accomplish her goals, as she knows there are so many restrictions by the society to follow the girl's dream. So she was finding herself in a small nest, narrow nest, and the wings were pressing its wings to the side, longing to fly, but she was unable to. But then she decided, tells that the poetess tells us that she began to realize her dreams and ambitions in her life and felt to urge to reach them, to make them true, that she, her dreams and ambitions is totally true, to be successful. The poetess wanted to be successful in her life. Hence, she started to fly like a bird in order to accomplish her goal in life with determination and perseverance. So the last stanza also tells us that the poetess explains her struggle of breaking free from the social barriers and restrictions. She left everything behind her back. She has broken all the social barriers by the people, the restrictions she has broken, and in order to fly high and reach to the destined goal. As a bird spread his wings and flies with the help of the wind, in the same way, she built within her the strong determination to pursue her dreams. The last stanza. She found the strength to follow and reach her goal within herself. So, this is the explanation, the message, the theme, and the summary of the poem. So I hope you have understood the poem Your World by Georgia Douglas Johnson. and please learn 8-line poems with the poet's name. And I will send you the question answers. Answer this question and appreciating the poem. But first of all, you write the poem in your fair copies. The full poem you will write in your fair copies along with the name of the poetess. And the summary also you will write in your fair copies. Thank you.